Dope Pride Nation, welcome back to another episode of Luke G's Field Review. Today we are going to be reviewing Detroit Lions second round pick out of Georgia, DeAndre Swift. If you're paying close attention and you see Frank Gore next to him and you're wondering to yourself, Luke, please tell me that you're not trying to say that his ceiling player comparisons is Frank Gore. That's exactly what I'm trying to tell you. In fact, not only do I believe that his ceiling is Frank Gore, I believe Frank Gore is a Hall of Fame running back. And to me, that's a damn good ceiling to have. But there are so many things that they have in common that I'm pretty sure you didn't think about. Like for the fact that DeAndre Swift got a chance to sit and not be used up as much because he basically ran behind Nick Chubb and Sony Michel. Well, little did you know that Frank Gore ran behind Clayton Portis and Willis McGahee. So, again, they share that. The height is very similar. Yes, there's a one-inch difference in terms of Frank Gore. But, you know, but if you look at the film, everything else match up. So, I'm going to give it to you as I see fit. This is the ceiling for what I believe DeAndre Swift can be for the Lions. And I'm telling you, when I show you what the floor is, you still will understand that I'm looking at film at this. I'm not just going by measurements and stats. I'm looking at the situation, running styles, and what they did, and to figure out where they can be at. So right off the gate, you'll see that right here for DeAndre Swift, he ran a 4.48 at the combine. This says a 4.63. I think they adjusted it due to the injuries, but one of the things that they don't talk about is Frank Gore had both knees replaced, I think. I think he had like MCL, ACL tears in both his knees. I could be wrong, but you guys tell me that if I'm right or wrong about that. Last time I checked, his combine rushing was a 4.53. So 4.48, 4.53, very close. Speed score right now for DeAndre Swift is a 105.3 compared to a 94.4. There's just not this huge gap. When you look at the burst score, 120.9 for Swift, 94.4. And that 90.4 is just him, I believe, right now. But nonetheless, I just want to show you this because they share so much in common. If you put the film on of Frank Gore and how he runs and then go and look at DeAndre Swift, I swear they're spitting images of each other. So let's see what they did in college. Okay, good people. Here we are. We're looking at the college careers, and right off the bat, you're going to notice some very interesting things. Both of them came out their junior year. Shocking. So shocking. But look at their junior years. Swift played in 14 games. Gore played in 12, right? Swift had 196 attempts. Gore had 197. Swift had 1,218 yards rushing. Gore had 945. Swift had 6.2 yard average. Gore had 4.8. Swift had 7 touchdowns. Gore had 8. And you may be saying to yourself, well, what's the difference? This Swift has 440 touches compared to 348. And I'm just showing you that this is coming from a guy who missed a lot of games due to injury, Frank Gore. That missed a lot of games due to injury. And the numbers are still close, people. Frank Gore got 17 touchdowns. He got 20, okay? When you go over and you look at the part of the game that I think stands out the most for them, is that receiving. When you go and look at that, look, right here, 73 receptions, 666 yards, 9.1 yard average, 5 touchdowns. All right, 23 receptions, 225 yards, 9.8 average, 0 touchdowns. And you're saying, well, how does that match up? Because when you watch this thing called film, people, it show you how they run in that screen, running back out the backfield set. And 25 touchdowns total from the scrimmage compared to 17. Now, if you really want to put it into a stronger perspective to see how much they got in common. I mean, it's scary when you think about it, which all you have to do is simply just take the amount of games that each person played. You got 43 games for DeAndre Swift in his three seasons, and that's comparable to the 28 games. So you're talking about 43 games for Swift, 28 for Frank Gore. That's a 15-game difference, and the touchdowns are that close. The rushing and receiving averages from scrimmage are that close. 6.9 for Swift, 5.9 for Gore. And I'm just telling you that you can make the argument on hard line numbers that, yes, these things are better, but I just wanted you to see that. Okay, now let's take a look at the floor. I know what y'all are probably thinking. What? The floor? His floor is Philip Lindsay? Yes. Again, I just watched the film. The film matched up. And based on what I see, their running styles and how they have to go through certain adversities, yes, it all matches up. Swift 5'8", Philip Lindsay 5'7". Swift 212, Philip Lindsay 184. Even though I think he's closer to like maybe 200. But okay. And if you just simply go and look at it, now the thing that's different is Philip Lindsay went undrafted. So for all those people who like to come in here and be like, what about this guy that you was talking about, Luke? He didn't even get drafted. Yep, Philip Lindsay wasn't drafted neither. But let's look at how much are they stacking up with each other. 4.48 in the 40 for DeAndre Swift, 4.44 for Philip Lindsay. Speed burst 105.3, 94.7. The burst score is 120.9 for Swift, 122 for Lindsay. And I'm just showing you that these are the things that you look at. I don't even care about these two right here just yet, because if you watch the film, the agility between both of them is very freaking scary. So let's go and look at their college careers. Okay, listen, we having fun with this. I hope y'all enjoying this, but listen, right out the gate, his junior year, we know what he did. Let's go and compare his junior year to the junior year of Philip Lindsay. Philip Lindsay's junior year, he had 244 attempts. So right out the gate, you're saying, well, he's already got more attempts than Swift. What do they have in common? They average on those attempts. They have high averages. He got 16 touchdowns in his junior year and followed it with 14 more. And right here, Swift got 7. The difference was that thing that people didn't want to talk about was that passing and that receiving side of it. So that receiving side of it, right here, 117 receptions, 1,084 yards and 3 touchdowns. 73 receptions, 661 yards and 5 touchdowns. 9.1 yard average, 9.3 yard average. Even more telling information is the number of plays. This guy right here, Philip Lindsay, had 882 plays compared to Swift's 513, but their numbers and averages are still pretty fair. 6.9 compared to 5.5, 25 touchdowns compared to the 39. And that's with Philip Lindsay playing all 4 years without necessarily playing behind a lot of people. I think the back he played behind might have got drafted. I can't remember his name. I'm drawing a blank. But that's where I see the floor. At the most extreme, we're going to look at who can be his most extreme floor in terms of a bonus person. All right, so here's my bonus floor person. I mean, like, if he's going to hit the floor and hit the floor hard, I think that Giovanni Bernard is where it lines up at. And I'm not saying Giovanni Bernard sucks. I like Giovanni Bernard, but I think he's underutilized, and I think that he didn't get the start that he should have got, and I understand it. But this would be the biggest floor. But again, 5'8", both of them, 212 versus 202, so he got about 10 pounds. And when we go through and we look at the the comparisons for the speed and the different scores like that, what we find is they're very close. Now, when I checked Giovanni Bernard's 40 time at his pro day, they said that he ran a 4.45. That's what they're claiming at the pro day, and that at the NFL combine they're saying that it was like a 4 448-453, something to that effect. So I'm like, whatever. But nonetheless, look at it. 448 compared to 453. And you just look at it for yourself. You see all of these different comparisons where you can absolutely see that these two players have a lot in common. When we go through and look at their college careers, you're going to see that Giovanni Bernard only played two seasons compared to the three seasons that DeAndre Swift played. All right, people. So again, for those who know that think I went to a stream, mind you, Giovanni Bernard is over here, and he's only played two seasons compared to the three of Swift. Giovanni Bernard got 423 attempts compared to the 440 that Mr. DeAndre Swift got. DeAndre Swift got 2,885 yards. Giovanni Bernard, 2,481. 6.6 average over here for the Russian, 5.9. What's even more telling is their final year. In his final year, 6.17, 6.2. So 6.7 versus 6.2. 7 touchdowns for Swift, 12 for Giovanni Bernard. And we're going to roll on over to that receiving thing because that's what these people look for. 92 receiving receptions compared to 73 for Swift. 666 yards receiving, 852, 9.3, 9.1, 5 touchdowns receiving, 6. I'm just giving y'all the reality that this is the absolute floor for a player like DeAndre Swift. So y'all tell me, people, what do y'all think? What is DeAndre Swift's ceiling? What is his floor? And give me the player that you think he best compared to when you're talking about that ceiling and the floor. Do you think I'm spot on? Do you think I'm crazy? If you think I'm crazy, just simply go and watch the film. I know y'all love watching highlights. Just watch the highlights. You don't even got to do like I do and sit through game upon snap to see it. You can simply watch the highlights and you will see that all of these people share something in common. That's it for now, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Also, make sure you hit that notification bell as well as that like button because we want to get this video in circulation. And make sure you check out the members of the DSA. Their link is in the description as well as the DSA official website. And make sure you support us, all right? As always, ladies and gentlemen, I leave you with this great piece of advice. Don't be no chump. Please do your research.